plus registrations, you know, data passionate individuals who wanted from all aspects, you know, wanted to participate and, you know, contribute. This was as diverse as we saw teams, you know, right there from the north of India to the absolute south, from east, west. We even had a team participating from Sri Lanka. So,
grateful and glad to be here, not just in the data industry, but in the tech industry, and at the time at which we are in life. This is the time when things are completely changing by day, by minute, if I can say. You know, I think she said, like, you know, what you said about Sunday afternoons, right? I would rather watch Narcos or something on Netflix. How many of you watch Narcos? Come on, guys, don't feel shy. Yeah. You know, if you really look at the dialogues, like, you have an option, you have a choice in Narcos, you know, plato or plamo, right? You guys understand that? Silver or lead. You take the money or you take the bullet. When it comes to data now, I think we have no choice. Everybody has to embrace this data-driven or data intelligence-based journeys. There is no choice.
Over the course of our journey in the bank, data has started becoming increasingly a very important asset. Towards this goal, we said that how do we differentiate ourselves from any other bank out there? The only way to do that is to build digital experiences which are powered by data. To this quest, we basically started off with this Datathon initiative. This was a first bank-led Datathon initiative, wherein the bank anonymized, non-inferenced, but opened up its production-grade data sets, set up the entire infrastructure for the data-passionate community to come and participate in helping us build these digital assets. This has been a massive and a tremendous journey, both a learning experience for us as well as our entire community. We had nearly 6,000 to 7,000 registrations for this Datathon, around 1,700 plus teams, which, you know, finally boiled down to 50 shortlists with whom we've been spending, you know, every day, every weekend over the last 1.5 months to build our data products. Today is the finale where we are going to be announcing the top 10 winners from this entire shortlist of 50, whom we will be further working with to put not only the ideas academically but into production. The whole objective being the community is coming together to enrich the experiences which they themselves would at the end benefit by, because they are the consumers of banking. This 6,000 data scientists, 1,700 teams have actually been as varied as possible. They have been from the absolute north to the, you know, teams in the south, teams in Calcutta in the east to Mumbai NCR region in the west. We even had participation from across the island, from Sri Lanka. There's a team from Sri Lanka who's also participated. So it's been as geographically spread as possible. Even in terms of the work experience, we have teams who have been in the second year of engineering to third year of engineering to teams who have 20 years of experience in data science in their respective fields. And the diversity is only matched by the novelty of their ideas. We've kind of, like, you know, from this initiative, been able to bring down 8 to 9 very concrete, very divergent ideas, which we hope that we will be able to work upon and put into production use, you know, in the next 9 to 12 months. That is the, you know, objective out of this particular Datathon. The evaluation that we did from these 50 teams has been on multiple parameters. It has been upon their completion, about the novelty of the idea, how they have actually gone about that, their approach, and whether their actual development matched with that particular code. So it's been decided by a panel which have evaluated every single team objectively on each of these criteria to, you know, come up with the shortlist of the 10. We do not want this to be a one-time event. We want this to be a continuous program wherein we will be running this as a banner. The idea is to basically make the population of India data literate. The idea is we need to be a powerhouse when it comes to data and machine learning. We will be having our roots spread in the academia. We'll be partnering with the IITs, Kharagpur, Mumbai, Chennai, BITS Pilani, kind of like helping these guys get a taste of production-grade data, work upon them, choose data science and analytics as their preferred field, and, you know, so that the future of the, what we feel, the future of the country will be very, very data literate.